Despite common perception, Washington State's towering Mount Rainier stratovolcano, which last erupted around 1,000 years ago, is not the tallest active volcano within North America. As instead, that honor goes to a towering glacier-covered volcano within the nation of Mexico, which is not only the tallest active volcano within North America, but also the tallest active volcano in the entire Northern Hemisphere. What I'm referring to is the massive 18,620-foot or 5,675-meter high Pico de Orizaba volcano, which is located 26 kilometers northwest of the city of Orizaba and straddles the border between the Mexican states of Puebla and Veracruz. Today, this volcano is fairly quiet, as since its last eruption in 1846, all that has occurred is weak degassing from its summit fumaroles. However, this is to be expected considering that such degassing can theoretically continue as much as tens of thousands of years after an eruption occurred, depending on the size of the solidifying at-depth body of magma linked to this volcano's last eruption. Yet, while this volcano is not showing any signs of unrest, the fact that Pico de Orizaba produced historical eruptions and still has an at-depth magma chamber means it is still active, likely to erupt again at some point in the future. So, how did this volcano reach such an impressive height? Unlike Russia's Klyuchevskoy volcano, which built itself at an incredibly higher speed in only 7,000 years, Pico de Orizaba has been intermittently growing for a much longer period of time, specifically 650,000 years. Also, Pico de Orizaba could best be described as the combination of four separate overlapping stratovolcanoes that formed during this time span. Pico de Orizaba is one of four volcanoes that exist along a 70-kilometer-long south-to-north trending stretch of land referred to as the Citlaltépetl-Cofre de Perote volcanic chain. The southernmost volcano in this chain, Pico de Orizaba, began forming approximately 650,000 years ago when a volume of basaltic andesite lava erupted onto the surface. Initially, these medium-gray to black lava flows originated from a vent with fine particles of ash known as a cinder cone. However, as eruptions continued, ash emissions and the explosivity of the eruption increased over time, eventually causing a larger stratocone to form in the place where a cinder cone once stood. Over the following 400,000 years, intermittent Volcanian eruptions built the stratovolcano to an impressive height of 5,300 meters, with the volcano largely erupting andesite during the majority of this period, and even sometimes erupting more viscous dacite lava that formed sizable lava flows. One of these dacite flows traveled an impressive 24.7 kilometers all the way to a spot just northwest of Tozongo 530,000 years ago. The Sierra Negra volcano soon began erupting 300,000 years ago, continuing to do so until 250,000 years ago. However, perhaps due to the recent emplacement of Sierra Negra to the southwest or abundant hydrothermal alteration occurring on the taller stratovolcano's northeast slope, that entire slope soon became highly unstable. Then, all of a sudden, 250,000 years ago, disaster struck as more than 15 cubic kilometers of this volcano collapsed to the northeast in a massive landslide. Moving at a speed of more than 100 kilometers per hour, this landslide would go on to cover an area of 250 square kilometers in an average of 70 meters thick of rock, reaching up to 48 kilometers distant. Then, from a large horseshoe-shaped crater grew another new volcanic cone which, over the next 234,000 years, built itself into a primarily gray-colored andesite stratovolcano. This stage also produced occasional dacite in addition to rhyolite lava domes. But this volcano would also eventually partially collapse in a massive event 16,500 years ago, causing some sections of a landslide to travel up to 86 kilometers away. Today, the hummocky terrain characteristic of such volcanic landslide deposits can be found west of the city of Huatusco. The top 600 meters of Pico de Orizaba formed during the last 16,000 years, largely consisting of volcanic explosive activity involving andesite lava, although for much of the last 5,000 years, this volcano has only erupted dacite. This not only formed the Chichimeco lava dome 4,500 years ago, but also a fresh-looking dacite lava flow on Orizaba's southwest flank 4,400 years ago. While Orizaba in the last 16,000 years has produced two VEI-4 and one VEI-5 eruptions, the vast majority of its eruptions would rate as a VEI-2 or VEI-3. Pico de Orizaba in recent times has only erupted from its summit, producing now buried small volume lava flows at a rate of about once a century between 1100 and 1846. While it has been 177 years since Orizaba's last eruption, this does not indicate anything unusual, as this volcano has previously gone more than 1,000 years without a single eruption occurring. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.